With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello everyone. So the question is, in the figure, the potential difference across 6 ohm resistor is 48 volt. Then the potential difference between A and B is, as you can see in this figure, there are two points A and B. A is on positive and B is on negative. This is positive and B is on negative. This is in negative. Now there is 6 volt on the voltage, potential difference across 6 ohm. This is 6 ohm and potential across this is 48 volt and current is flowing in this direction. As you can see that this 12 ohm and 6 ohm, these both are in parallel direction. So the net resistance of these two will be, suppose RP1 equals to net resistance in parallel, that is 12 into 6 upon 12 plus 6, because in parallel resistance the net resistance is given by RP1, that is equals to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. R1 is 12 ohm, R2 is 6 ohm. So that means the value of RP1 is coming out to be 4 ohm. So if I draw a new circuit and these three are also in parallel, as you can see, 30 ohm, 15 ohm and 10 ohm. These three are also in parallel. Suppose the net resistance of this is RP2. So RP2 is basically written by RP2, that is 1 upon RP2, 1 upon RP2, that is equals to 1 upon 30 plus 1 upon 15 plus 1 upon 10. After simplifying this, we will have the value of 1 upon RP2, that is equals to 1 upon 5. That means the net resistance of this is 5 ohm. Okay, now this we have 4 ohm and this we have 5 ohm. And you must remember two things. First thing is that in parallel, the voltage is remain constant and in series, the current is remain same. In parallel, voltage remains same or constant. Okay, same or constant. And in series, current is remain constant or same or constant. Now, if I draw this circuit again, then this circuit is look like, this is A point. This is point A, which is positive, and A. Now, this is the RP1, which is coming out to be 4 ohm, RP1. And the voltage along this is 48 volt, because voltage is remain constant in parallel. Now, second is RP2, which is RP2. This is RP1 and this is 5 ohm, and there is one more, which is 8 ohm, and this is point B, which is in negative. Okay, now 48 volt is the potential difference between RP1. Now current is flowing in this direction. So current for this can be written by, current is basically, that is equals to voltage upon, current is given by the voltage upon resistance, V upon R. I equals to V upon R from Ohm's law. That means current is equals to 12 ampere. The current which is flowing, that is 12 ampere. Now I already told you that in series current is remain constant, and these three are now in series, 4 ohm, 5 ohm and 8 ohm. These three are now in series. That means current in all circuits are, current is same, that is 12 ampere. So now voltage for this, I will calculate the voltage for RP2. So the voltage will be V equals to IR. I is 12 and this is 5. R is 5, that is equals to 60 volt. So the voltage across 5 ohm is 60 volts. Similarly for 8 ohm, the voltage is equals to 12, that is current into 8, and that is equals to 96 volt. Okay, so now we have three voltages, the voltage 48 volt. This is plus, this is minus. Now this is for 4 ohm. This is for 5 ohm. That is 60 volt. This is plus, this is minus. And this is for 8 ohm. This is plus, this is minus, and this is 96 volt. That means the potential difference across A and B, potential difference across A and B, that is equals to 48 plus 60 plus 96, and the total potential difference across A and B coming out to be 204 volt. Okay, so let's check the options. The third option, which is 204 volt, is the correct option. Okay, thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.